What's up, guys? Driver Man here, rideshare channel, all about Uber and food delivery. So make sure that you subscribe so you're getting the latest tips and news all about that world. The title of today's video is Uber Passenger Sounds Rude? Cancel it. What do I mean by that? Basically, I'm referring to an instance where perhaps the customer calls you, which I've had happen before. Maybe they're asking, oh, where are you? What's going on? Or they're like, oh, I've changed like my location. The address is not that. I'm actually going to be over here. And that's normal. Those things like that are going to happen. But you can gauge the way that the person is, obviously, from that conversation. So if they're sounding like they're maybe like really flustered or in a bad mood and they're not being polite, then why would you want that person in your car? You know what I mean? It's really not worth it, because that person, not only are they going to be rude during the ride, they're probably going to try to like boss you around, not going to tip you, and that's for sure, and most likely give you a bad rating as well. So there's a number of reasons why you don't want to deal with that. The other one, of course, being just having that bad energy in your car. You don't want that environment in your car. So I'll tell you, one time I had a guy call me because I wasn't there at the pickup spot. The problem was he put in the wrong address. So the street name was the same, but the address was like 20 minutes away from where he actually was, as far as the address that he had put in. So the problem is, I get out, I accept the ride, and I drive for 5 minutes, get to a location, and there's nobody there. So he gets in touch with me after a minute. I was about to call him, and he says, oh, what's going on? Where are you? And I'm like, I'm here at the location, where are you? This is the address, what's going on? And he says, well, I'm here. So I say, oh, what's the address? Are you sure you put in the right address? And he's giving me the address. And it turns out that the address was actually 15, 20 minutes away. So I'm like, well, yeah, you put in the wrong address. I'm like, you're waiting for me. He's like, listen, let's not waste time. And had an accent kind of like that. And so just the fact that he spoke like that was like, listen. I was like, you know what? I'm not even gonna deal with this. As soon as he said that, I hung up and canceled the ride. Why? Because a guy like that, who's like saying, listen, is going to try to like control the conversation, obviously. He's trying to control the situation. And he's gonna try to control the circumstances while he's inside of your car. He or she, it doesn't matter if it's male or female. That's just not something that you want to have to worry about dealing with. So obviously, I canceled the ride because I don't want to have to deal with somebody who's going to be like that in my car. You can just tell. So my suggestion is, do yourself that favor. If you happen to get on the phone with your customer before the ride for whatever reason, either because they call you or maybe you call them, because they're not there and you're wondering where they're at, or you want to confirm like, oh, I don't see you here. Where are you specifically? Are you around the corner? Or, you know, whatever. Maybe they're still inside the bar or they're still inside their house. These things happen. And if they sound like normal and cool, okay, great. But yeah, if they're sounding like, you can kind of gauge what their attitude is like. They're arrogant, something like that. Rude, just entitled. Yeah, don't worry about it. Just cancel it and let them be somebody else's headache. Or hopefully they'll learn from that experience as well. Be like, oh, he abruptly hung up on me right after I said that. I guess maybe drivers don't like that when you speak to them that way. Well, dude. So hopefully they'll be nicer to the next person. And I know for a fact they usually are. Not necessarily if they're rude, but customers who for some reason have had like two or three drivers cancel on them in a row, Sometimes it's been because it's like a tough pickup spot, and so the driver doesn't want to go there. It's difficult for them to get there, and so they've had to cancel on this person. And so this customer has called maybe like two or three different Uber drivers, and they've been canceled on after like a minute or 30 seconds. Oh my, and they're like, you know, you pick them up and you're basically the hero. They're like, oh my God, thank you for coming here. I had like three Uber drivers cancel on me already, and I was just trying to get a ride. So that can happen, you know, after them being canceled on, you know, three or four times, or even just twice or once, they're much nicer because they're just happy that they were able to get a ride. Because there is the fact that, you know, they still need you at the end of the day, they still need a ride, and if people keep canceling on them, then they're pretty much screwed. So just want to make sure that you guys had that tidbit of information. If you're new, maybe you haven't experienced that yet. If you've been around, you probably have. But I wanted to share that with you so that you have that in your back pocket. Boom. And make sure that you use that. Do that for yourself. You don't want to deal with that. So you guys have a great weekend. Remember to subscribe. I'm doing these twice a week. And give me a like as well. All right. Have a great weekend, guys.